Hi, I'm Tom, and that's me. I thought I'd introduce myself, and thank you for watching what is my 65th video. Because this video has a lot of text, I thought I'd do some narration. Hope you don't mind it. And my big thanks to all the people who granted me permission to use their beautiful photographs. Big thank you. Frank W. Woolworth, at the age of 27, opened his first 5-cent store in Utica, New York, in February of 1879. It closed 3 months later. Undeterred, however, with retail in his blood, his second store in Lancaster, Pennsylvania, opened in June of 1879 and was very successful. With his younger brother, Charles, as manager, they opened the first Five and Dime store in Scranton, Pennsylvania, in November of 1880. From this beginning, Frank Woolworth would build a retail global empire of over 3,000 stores. Among the numerous notable designs by architect Cass Gilbert are the Minnesota State Capitol Building, the Alexander Hamilton United States Custom House in New York City, and the United States Supreme Court Building. The Woolworth Building, located at 233 Broadway in Manhattan, is 60 stories tall, with a 30-story base and a 30-story tower. From 1913 to 1930, it was the tallest building in the world. There's a little Ken Burns effect for you. And speaking of Ken Burns, it's a major oversight that he's not been awarded the Presidential Medal of Freedom. Ken Burns and his documentaries are indeed national treasures. Frank Woolworth considered the entire 24th floor as his office area, with his personal office being referred to as the Empire Room. Across from the desk, you'll notice the large portrait of French Emperor Napoleon Bonaparte. Frank was an admirer. In 2012, the top 30 floors were sold to an investment group which was headed by the developer Alchemy Properties. The space has been converted into 33 luxury condominiums, topped off by the five-story Pinnacle Penthouse. In 1930, the Woolworth Building became the world's second tallest, being surpassed by its Manhattan neighbor, the Chrysler Building. However, only a year later, the Empire State Building reached even higher into the heavens to become the world's tallest skyscraper. When Frank Woolworth passed away in April of 1919, at the age of 66, Charles became chairman of the board of the F.W. Woolworth Company, and he served in that capacity until 1944. When Frank asked his younger brother Charles to manage the new store in the growing and bustling city of Scranton, Charles decided to make the city his permanent residence. Charles died in Scranton on January 7, 1947, at the age of 90. He is buried in the nearby town of Dunmore. The final home for Charles was a three-story Victorian mansion that was built in 1910, and it's located just a few blocks from the downtown area. After years of being vacant, Hunt Slonem, the renowned American painter, sculptor, and real estate investor, he purchased the dilapidated house in 2015 for $295,000. He spent several years and a small fortune renovating it. The 8,300 square feet, five bedroom mansion was put up for sale by Slonem in late 2020 with an asking price of $1.35 million.